Hey guys. Okay, I just want to thank everybody for the tips and tricks of trying to match my face with my neck since it changed colors. I'm so happy. I'm gonna try a lot of things you guys had showed me, told me about that fab. I'm just gonna try different moisturizers. I just wanna try something new. But you guys, I found my match. Yes, I did. I surely did. Found it. Okay, so first of all, excuse the hair. It looks a mess. You see, I just threw it on to look decent for y'all. Cause this, I'm just curling my hair, so it looks a mess right now. So, yeah. If you're new to my channel, my hair don't look like this all the time. Sometimes. When. Anyways, y'all family. So, yeah. Since I do see my face getting lighter, and one of my subs mentioned the black soap. But the thing with that black soap, I thought about it, I really did. But I've been using it for like 2-3 years now, I think. About 2 years at the most. And I never had a problem with foundation change messing up because of my black soap. Now, I didn't wear, like I said, I didn't wear makeup this time last year. So maybe that's the problem, I don't know. But I don't wear foundation all the time. Like, I haven't worn foundation like 2 months. So it's not the foundation that's the problem. It's just trying to find a good powder. I can find foundation like the Maybelline liquid, the mousse, all that worked for me. But it wasn't working. It just recently started working because my skin changed colors. But those work fine for me. It's just the powders I have a problem with. So like I said in my last video, ginger number 4 is what I'm sticking with as of now because it gives me the coverage I like. And it's the closest thing to my skin color. This is like exactly my tone in this thing right here. Exactly. And I love it. I really do. So I was mad it wasn't working, but I found how to make it work. So I don't know if you can see by the camera, but my face is matching my neck. And you know how I noticed? I went outside and I looked in the rear view mirror. Okay. So it's the truth. So, it do match. I'm happy. At first, when I put it on, I was kind of like yellowish, really light. But I know sometimes, I know some people say, like on YouTube, that when they first put their foundation on, it still looks light for a while until, like, later on in the day, it starts sinking in the skin. So, I think that's what I got to get used to instead of trying to see an exact color that I want. I need to get, like, probably, like, this tone and just let it sink in my skin. But I'm using MAC. Ooh, I paid enough for it. You know what I'm saying? So, I haven't used this since I made that MAC and CoverGirl video. I don't think I used it in that video. It's been a long time. So, I pulled it out since I felt that my skin was getting a little lighter. I pulled this out because I swear up and down, I am not an NW45. I am an NW50. But these MAC people swear up and down, I'm 45. And I'm not. And it's like they're trying to brainwash you to believe that you're really 45. Because I'd be like, this is not my skin color at all. I mean, it really isn't. And the Maybelline Dream Mousse Liquid, that's my color. Even though it blends the same way as MAC, but the color is something different about it. It's more red in the liquid rather than this. It's more yellow on this one. So anyway, I put a little bit of this on. Not a lot, because I don't like my face looking cakey, and this makes me look extremely cakey. That makes me look really, really fake and like a pancake. It really does. So, I don't use it at all, but I use a little bit of it. You know, I got my concealer brush by Posh. Really nice brushes, you guys. Posh, get it from Kmart, really nice brushes. So, I just got it, and I dotted it on just a little bit, and then I just buffed it in really fast. That's all I did, and I put my Fix Plus after that, so it get a little darker, because I know my Fix Plus really darkens my powders a little bit, so I just did that, and then I put on my number 4, and then I just buffed it in also on top of that, and it went perfectly. I don't know if I mentioned in the last video, but it's certain foundation that go with certain powders, like my Dream Mousse. I cannot wear that at all with skin finish. Won't look right. It makes me look gray, nasty, and muddy. I can't wear my mousse with my MAC skin finish. So I noticed that as I get more familiar with makeup products, certain foundations don't go with certain powders at all. So maybe that was a problem. I was having, because like I said, I haven't used MAC in a while, and since my skin is changing, I went back to it since I am light. I mean, this is lighter than me. I feel that it really is. But once I put this on with my Milani powder number 4, and then I added my Fix Plus on my brush and blended it, it looked great. As you can see, it looks great. Like, really does. And I sat in front of this mirror for a good hour trying to mix and match my foundations with my powders, because I don't wear foundation. I just want to wear powder because I don't feel like I really need foundation. Like, I don't feel like I need it. Even though foundation is nice to have, I like to have it because, I mean, I like to go out with foundation. I'll go to the club with foundation on. But, like, the school work, I don't wear makeup hardly anytime. So, but I found that that foundation goes really good with my Milani. So, I can't wear the Milani by itself anymore until I figure out why my skin's changing colors or find a good powder, because I just need a really, really good powder. Really good powder that matches me. Like Milani does. But since it's not working right now, I'm going to just have to wear foundation and blend it in with this to get my perfect tone. And I want to give a shout out to Miss Shonda. Hey, girl. She sent me Sally Girl Shadows and my prizes when I won the 80s contest. Thank you, girl. I'm addicted to these. These things are the business. I have it on my eyes right now. Right down here. All in my crease and in my lid right here. It's espresso. This color. And in my highlight, I have beige. She bought me both. I think she bought me the beige and she bought me brick. I wear brick all the time. I love them. So I bought me espresso. I want to get some more too. So, oh yeah. Also, an update on the prizes. Guys, I'm so sorry. I caught the flu. I had personal problems. And I just been busy. So I haven't mailed the prizes yet. You don't believe me? I can make a video show you the prizes in my room, because I know some people be on YouTube lying to people about their prizes and they'll never get them. I'm sending them, okay? I just don't want you to be like, where's my stuff? Because I really do have them. I do have them. I just been really busy. And so I told y'all in the message that it may take a while, but I am going to send you prizes because they're in my room right now. I want to get them out of the way, but I just never have time to do it because the post office is like on the other side of town, so I can mail them off. So it's just taking some time, but I will send you prizes. I haven't forgotten. So, I'm just saying y'all thank you for all your help, and I found my perfect match. I'm going to show you pictures at the end with the flash on, because you can really see how skin looks with the flash on. So, I took a picture with the flash, so you can see how it matches my neck. So, that's it, y'all. Bye.
Oh, baby, how you doing? You know, I'm going to come right to the chase, Some women were made, but me, myself, I like to think that I was created for a special purpose. Now, what's more special than you? You feel me? It's on, baby, let's get lost. You don't need to call into work, cause you the boss. For real, want you to show me how you feel. I consider myself lucky, that's a big deal. Why? Well, you got the key to my heart, but you ain't gonna need it.